It's a colossal project, an unprecedented construction that could soon take shape. A few months ago, the Chinese government gave the go-ahead for the construction of the world's largest hydroelectric dam. With a capacity of 60 gigawatts, the Motuo megadam will be 3 times more powerful than the current record holder, the Three Gorges Dam. It's an insane project, built on the world's highest river, at over 5,000 meters above sea level, the Yarlung Tsangpo in the Tibetan Himalayas. Here, the construction company PowerChina intends to build the world's largest and most powerful hydroelectric dam, at an estimated cost of $137 billion. On December 25th, the China news agency announced the government's approval of the project, which has been under discussion for several years. It's another step in China's race to build dams on the headwaters of Asia's great rivers. However, the location of the dam poses a major problem for the construction of such infrastructure. Not only logistically, of course, since it requires engineers from all over the world, but also in terms of human rights. The dam could devastate a large part of the region, destroying entire villages and temples and displacing countless people. Finally, on a geopolitical level, India does not look favorably on this project and is already preparing its riposte. Far from being a long, quiet river, the reasons for and conditions of the construction of this unprecedented dam are a tidal wave with many consequences. This is the engineering marvel and geopolitical tinderbox that is the Motuo Dam. While it's not unusual for China to spend billions of dollars on a single infrastructure project, the Motuo Dam is in a league of its own. As mentioned above, the total cost of the project is estimated at $137 billion, or nearly 1 trillion yuan. If this estimate turns out to be correct, as it probably will, the Motuo Dam will be the most expensive infrastructure project China is currently undertaking. That's 4 times the cost of the Three Gorges Dam on the Yangtze River. China's GDP in 2024 was $18.8 trillion, and the Motuo Dam figure constitutes roughly 3.5% of its national general public budget expenditure. A substantial investment, but well within the reach of the second wealthiest country on the planet. Although Beijing's yet to provide any details, we do know that the dam could come into service as early as 2023. The question is, why are they doing it? The short answer is renewable energy. In response to increasing international pressure, Chinese President Xi Jinping made an announcement back in September 2020 that came as a surprise to many. He announced that China would pledge to be carbon neutral by the year 2060. As laudable as this environmental motive is, it's not the only one. The Chinese government's also considering selling some of the electricity it produces to some of its neighbors. The announcement drew skepticism, and that skepticism continues today. China currently relies on coal for more than half of its electricity. Overall, it's by far the most polluting country. Over 30% of global carbon dioxide emissions come from China, and those emissions have been increasingly significant since 2010. In an effort to clean up its image, China's trying to reduce its considerable carbon footprint, which is partly due to the fact the country's long been considered the world's factory, with all the pollution that entails. A long-term project. In 2003, China inaugurated the Three Gorges Dam on the Yangtze River, which remains today the most powerful hydroelectric dam currently in operation, at a staggering 22.5 gigawatts of installed capacity. The current runner-up is also Chinese. The Baihetan Dam's been partially operational since 2021. Located on the Jinsha River, its installed capacity will eventually reach 16 gigawatts. That's almost a quarter of the installed capacity of France's nuclear power plants. Both of these dams have already demonstrated China's capacity to shatter records when it comes to ambitious hydroelectric projects. But curiously, they've also already demonstrated the potential for controversy and negative consequences, in particular, the Three Gorges Dam. Experts estimate that, By building the Three Gorges Dam and using it to generate unprecedented amounts of renewable energy, enough to power more than 80 million homes in 2020, China has paradoxically also displaced at least 1.3 million people and destroyed a significant number of archaeological sites and natural features. The dam's other intended purpose, which was to try and mitigate flooding that's affected the area of the Yangtze River for years, has been questioned by experts as well, who point out that the dams likely led to increased earthquakes and landslides in the area. The degree to which China's been perturbed by these unfortunate consequences is illustrated by the scale of the dam they're now racing to finish. The Motuo Dam is more than just bigger than the Three Gorges Dam. It's in fact designed to generate almost three times more power. The shocking but serious goal is to reach 60 gigawatts of installed capacity. It's only 1.4 gigawatts less than the installed capacity of the entire French nuclear fleet, according to EDF's 2025 figures. Many countries, for example, Thailand, Argentina, or Egypt to name a few, could run year-round on well under half the dam's total energy. Even China itself, the world's greatest consumer of total energy, at more than double the rate of its runner-up, the United States, will be able to cover as much as 6.5% of its total energy needs from this one humongous dam alone. The implications of such astronomical power are stunning enough to beg the question, how is it even possible to achieve? What are the nuts and bolts of what PowerChina is actually building, and how does it work? The intricacies of successfully constructing a hydroelectric dam and turning it on are vast, but the concept behind them is surprisingly simple. Basically, dams hold back water, then selectively release it through huge pipes with turbines inside. The turbines spin rapidly, thus spinning magnets inside copper coils, and voila, out flows electricity. In short, the power of the plant depends on the height of the head and the flow of water. To build such a device that's theoretically capable of powering entire nations year-round, the first and arguably most important step is to choose the ideal water source. The Yarlung Tsangpo is an exceptionally large and powerful river, and it also covers an exceedingly large drop in elevation. Originating in the Tibet Autonomous Region, the river flows from west to east, forming the largest canyon in the world. That's why China's so interested in the river's hydraulic pressure, especially in a section where it loses 2,000 meters of vertical drop in just 50 kilometers. Here, where the river makes a big bend, PowerChina engineers would dig tunnels about 20 kilometers long through a mountain, the 7,782-meter Himalayan peak of Namcha Barwa, to divert water to turbines and back to the river's lower reaches. From China's perspective, the site's an obvious gold mine. But the Yarlung Tsangpo Grand Canyon is more than just a geological marvel offering great opportunity. When one takes a deeper look, the dam's construction could have serious repercussions, both geopolitically with India and Bangladesh, and for local populations and the environment. By reducing the river's flow, the dam could weaken the livelihoods of downstream farming and fishing communities. We'll return to these issues in a moment. We've discussed what the Motuo Dam project is, and we've discussed why China's so driven to invest so heavily in it. Now we must ask another key question. Where is it? This seems like the easiest question of all, but it isn't. In fact, you're likely to get different answers based on who you ask and what their political views are. Ask a CCP official and they'll probably say the Motuo Dam's being constructed in one of China's five autonomous regions, the big one down over by the Himalayas. Ask one of the roughly 3.6 million people living in that region, however, and they'll tell you the dam's being built in Tibet by a foreign invader that's occupied their country for the last 70 years. Resentment is fueled by the violent history of China's major infrastructure projects in the region. A report released on December 5, 2024 by the NGO International Campaign for Tibet, or ICT, lists at least 193 dam projects in Tibet since 2000. Only 28% of these proposed dams are currently operational, but another 34% are either in the preparation stage or currently under construction. These numbers may be underestimated. Data on the subject is scarce or has been made inaccessible by Beijing. According to the NGO, all these dams could generate more than 270 gigawatts of hydroelectric power, equivalent to the production of Germany. The sheer size and number of these projects raise questions about respect for the rights of local people. The International Campaign for Tibet estimates that between 750,000 and 1 million people could be displaced or evicted as a result of this exponential development. According to their database, at least 144,000 people are known to have been displaced and resettled because of a hydroelectric dam in Tibet. In addition to negatively altering ecologically unique ecosystems by flooding farmland, forests, grasslands, and wildlife habitats, and carving up mountainsides, dams interrupt the flow of aquatic life, soil, water, and nutrients essential to sustain life in downstream countries, the association laments. While specific figures are hard to come by, reports from Tibetan sources claim that a significant portion of the energy from these dams is being exported outside of Tibet. A 2021 article in the Tibetan Review stated that nearly 9 billion kilowatts of clean energy produced on Tibet went to 14 provinces in China between 2015 and 2021. Tibetans are rarely, if ever, consulted in the implementation of these ambitious high-energy projects, despite the fact that they pose significant changes to Tibetan land, Tibetan cultural sites, and Tibetan daily life. To get a sense of how impactful Chinese dams can be, and how vehement Tibetan protests can be in response, one needs to look no further than the recent fiasco surrounding the construction of the Gangto Dam. The Gangto Dam, or Kamtok Dam as it's known by Tibetans, is another Chinese hydropower project that shares many similarities with the Motuo Dam. For one, it's also located on a key Tibetan river, the Jinsha. Tibetans are also widely and fervently opposed to it. The Gangto Dam would submerge multiple Tibetan monasteries, including the Wanto Monastery, which has been there for 700 years. Both the upper and lower Wanto villages face complete relocation. Even though the thousands of implicated residents were reportedly never consulted in any meaningful way, the dam would also submerge various meditation caves, burial grounds, and pilgrimage routes that hold a huge significance to the Tibetan people in the region. Locals would not only lose their homeland and their traditional way of life, but they would likely be relocated to Chinese-built resettlement housing far away and in a completely different environment. The combination of all these factors inspired something relatively rare in Tibet. In 2024, a large-scale protest movement erupted over the Gangto Dam, largely led by monks from the Wanto Monastery. Hundreds of thousands of Tibetans took to the streets and began conducting peaceful protests in February 2024. They wielded signs, chanted slogans through megaphones, and even staged more dramatic gestures, such as kneeling in front of a monastery that was to be flooded. They responded by cracking down. Reports began trickling out of mass arrests, home invasions, and drawn-out interrogations. There were even reports of widespread beatings. These alleged beatings included older monks in their traditional robes who were often leading the protests. And a BBC journalist named Tessa Wong found that at least some of the beatings led to serious injury. However, reports on the protests and the subsequent crackdown have been hard to come by. Journalists have had an exceedingly hard time getting access to the region, or to sources, due to Chinese authorities tightening restrictions following the ordeal. These crackdowns were not airtight, however. Videos soon leaked and were published online, revealing to the world the drama that was unfolding. While shocking, the events are hardly unprecedented. In fact, since 2000, China's relocated nearly 1 million Tibetans, according to Human Rights Watch. The protests over the Gangto Dam also marked a relatively rare moment in history where Tibetans felt emboldened to rebel against the Chinese government. And all available evidence suggests those protesting suffered dire consequences for doing so. Now, let's turn our attention back to the Motuo Dam. China's not yet released much in the way of concrete stats when it comes to construction. We do know that, at the time of this video, China intends to begin actual construction in 2029. This is anticipated to be a roughly four-year process, leading to the dam becoming fully operational in 2033. China's not publicly released figures to estimate how many Tibetans will be displaced by the Motuo Dam. However, we know the largest dam China's completed so far displaced at least 1.3 million people, as mentioned earlier. And for what it's worth, the Motuo Dam's going to be three times as powerful as that dam. While power doesn't necessarily correlate directly with impact to the surrounding area, we could safely assume the impact of the Motuo Dam won't be negligible. Medog County, where the dam is to be built, is less populated than other areas of Tibet where large dams have been built or proposed. But still, it seems inevitable that it'll involve large-scale relocations, and not yet knowing how large-scale makes it, if anything, even more disconcerting. Add to this the possibility of more holy sites and monasteries being submerged underwater, and the potential cultural impact becomes even more significant. There are also serious environmental concerns. This region is one of the most biodiverse in Tibet. By altering downstream water flow patterns, this biodiversity is expected to be disrupted, perhaps substantially. The area is also particularly prone to seismic activity and landslides. The reservoir for the largest dam in human history is destined to be huge, and that huge water mass could have a dangerous effect on the geological safety of the area. There's a real risk of earthquakes leading to landslides, floods, and mudslides downstream, warns Deccan Palmo, a Tibetan researcher interviewed by RFI. As New York Times reporters point out, Chinese authorities reported cracks in five hydroelectric dams in Tibet after a 7.1 magnitude earthquake in January 2025. And there's more. Not only Tibetans, but numerous other people depend on the Yarlung Tsangpo River as a water source, most notably India and Bangladesh. A Lowy Institute analysis in 2020 revealed that China's damming of Tibetan waterways has deep implications for its leverage over downstream nations, most significantly India. Taken together, these multiple dams could affect the water resources of up to 2 billion people, according to Jacqueline Eustache Brinio, French senator and chair of the International Information Group on Tibet. India and Bangladesh are concerned that the Motuo Dam will alter the natural flow of the river, potentially disrupting access to water for agriculture, drinking, and other essential human needs. In fact, India is so concerned about this issue that it's considered building counter-projects to limit the potential negative impacts of the Chinese dam, including a hydroelectric project in the Upper Siang district of Arunachal Pradesh. This will provide 11 gigawatts. And if the project's highly controversial, it's also because China's provided little precise information about it. According to the New York Times, even the basic design of the dam is unknown. The Motuo Dam's also close to the border with the Indian state of Arunachal Pradesh, an area where the two sides fought a war in 1962, a situation that reignites certain tensions between these two Asian giants. Faced with India's warnings on the subject, Beijing assures that there will be no negative repercussions. A skeptical response, as some viewers may already know, China's disrupted water sources on a multinational scale before. In fact, causing full-on periodic droughts in Vietnam, Cambodia, and Thailand by damming the Mekong River. For its part, the Middle Kingdom claims to have a legitimate right to dam rivers, as it's done until now. To be continued. We'll see you next time on Looking 4.